We interrupt this episode of Bob Cleans His Yard for this special word from Stark Raving Hazelnuts.
So we got tons of Icarus. We got tons of the woman, the deaf one. Like, they're all over here, okay? Between the Eternals and Black Panther and Doctor Strange, no matter the price, no matter the discount, these things are not moving.
Okay, so what do we got here? We got a toy company in trouble. We got layoffs. We got slumping sales. Big slumping sales for action figures. And to make matters worse, liquidation centers across the country are being filled to the brim with unwanted, unsaleable Marvel toys for characters that nobody asked for and for films that not enough people saw. And everybody's blaming
Disney.
Is it Disney's fault? I don't know, but I do know this. It's a systemic problem that goes a lot further than LA, New York, and Boise, Idaho. It's happening in China, too. And it's even happening in the knockoff toy market. And that's something that nobody is talking about.
So here we are at Treasure Hunt, a local treasure hunt, and look at this, Akuma stuff, Shuri stuff, like Akuma headdresses. This stuff is piling up here at 50% off, and it's not moving. But it gets crazier on the other side of this aisle. Okay, and on the end cap here, still in Treasure Hunt, 50% off Black Panther bedding. Look at this. It's mental, 50% off. We got comforters, we got sheets, pillowcases, and the madness continues. Look at this, more sheets, Black Panther sheets, 50% off, and nothing is moving. Insane. So knockoff toy friends, from my video there, it's quite obvious that Disney, the MCU, and maybe even Hasbro are entering into some turbulent times. Now, as you all know, and that has been widely reported in the media, on YouTube, and the internet, Hasbro is in a wee spot of trouble. Rough times ahead, 13% drop in action figures from 2022 to 2023, and if you're talking globally, that number skyrockets to 24%. And as you all know, during Christmas of 2023, Hasbro laid off 1,100 employees. Pink slips across the board. Clean out your lockers. Don't forget your sneakers. Merry Christmas from the boys at Hasbro. And that's in addition to 800 people they laid off earlier in 2023. Now, the effects of this were forthcoming because in November 2023, November 10th, their stock price, when Wynn got heard of these pink slips, the stock price dropped to 43 cents a share, which a few months ago back in September was at 73 cents a share. And if that's not bad enough, during the heyday of Marvel 2019, when you had Endgame, Spider-Man Far From Home, and Captain Marvel ripping through the summer box office, the Hasbro stock price was at $123.67 a share. Now, it's since rebounded to over 62 cents a share today, but there is no doubt that there is still rough waters ahead for the boys at Hasbro. Now, you're probably asking yourself, hey, Johnny, how does that possibly affect the knockoff Hasbro Titan Hero toy market in China? But it has. Okay, so what evidence do we have that the Hasbro decline and the drop in action figure sales is somehow affecting knockoff toys in China? Well, we turn your attention to a company called DC Toys. Most of their product is generic children's toys. And what I mean by generic children's toys is everything from girls' dolls to boys' train sets, soccer balls, Rubik's cubes, plastic puzzles, sporting equipment, anything that runs on batteries or has an electronic gizmo attached to it, made of rubber, made of silicone. That is 99.9% of the business and toys that DC Toys produces in China. However, they do have a strong footprint of knockoff toys, and they always have. Their high point was 2019 during the Endgame Spider-Man and Captain Marvel film phase, which saw Marvel, DC, and Disney explode in popularity. Now, during that time, they produced figures like everything you see behind me. The Flash, this Hulkbuster knockoff, this Batman knockoff, this Avengers jazz drum set, this Wonder Woman, this Thanos mask, and this really cool Endgame Iron Man figure that comes with a mask. But my point is this. This is Endgame. This is Avengers 4 Endgame. But the packaging has not changed in 5 years. The toys have stopped being recycled into new packages. It's the same old stuff. In fact, if you go on to AliExpress, you will find toys like this Flash Avengers 4, which I had on the show recently. You'll still find this on AliExpress for as cheap as $9.22 plus a couple bucks shipping. 2 years ago, that same toy would have cost you almost $18 to $19 to get. Wow, it's really a significant drop. Now, when I went to DC Toys recently on their website, I checked out their new release section. The new releases from January to May, they have about 5,000 SKUs of new toys. 5,000! That's a lot of new toys! You know how many are Marvel related? About 20. And the biggest figure was a 6-inch Spider-Man. That's nothing. Now, I know what a lot of you are probably saying. A lot of you are probably saying, oh, well, you know, Marvel's probably cracking down on the copyright and the bootlegging and the knockoffs. They're not cracking down on anything. You can go onto AliExpress. You can go onto any site in Southeast Asia, and knockoffs are everywhere. They're knocking off American product. They're knocking off Japanese product. There's no end to knockoffs. But there is a suspicious decline in this Hasbro Titan Hero stuff. It's not being renewed, okay? You're still finding the same old figures in the same old five-year-old boxes, and I find that suspicious. Now, I phoned the guy, or emailed rather, the guy at DC Toys to place an order for a few more of these. He told me they're not making them anymore. And I go, what do you mean you're not making them anymore? You've made these figures for years. You just keep recycling them. What do you mean you're not making them? He says, we're not making them anymore. And that is suspicious. Now, does all of this knockoffs of Hasbro toys, do the decline in this and the disinterest in this to repeat and remake these toys for knockoff toy companies have to do and reflect with the downturn for Hasbro in the US and globally on legit product? Okay, so we've pretty much established that the legit figures, the legit Hasbro, Walmart, Target figures aren't selling overseas, then there's no incentive for knockoff toy companies to continue producing them with new boxes, new advertising, and new styles. Because if they're not selling overseas, they're probably not going to sell in China either, even at a discounted price. In fact, this Wonder Woman that was widely available on AliExpress in 2022, you can't find it anywhere now. It's gone. Now, the big question is, why did this happen in the first place? How did this happen to Hasbro? Well, old Johnny Bananas has got on the internet, and I found the top three reasons or excuses or ideas put forth by fans as to why we're in this predicament. Let's go through them. Number one is quality control. Fans who collect Marvel toys, the generic Marvel toys, the Walmarts, the Targets, the simple basic tie-in figures agree that the quality has dropped. Poor castings, poor detail, subpar plastic that is more breakable, and the paint on the figures is really not all that great. And to be honest with you, some of them aren't even competing with the knockoffs they're up against. So quality control, as of late, is a big issue, according to some fans. Other fans have cited another problem: Marvel fatigue. This is a big one. After Far From Home, it's no secret that Marvel Disney box office receipts have tanked substantially. And this is a real problem, because when there's disinterest in the theater and there's disinterest in the films that come out in the theater, then people aren't going to buy movie tie-in toys. And that's just common sense. So that is a big one. So Marvel needs to really pull their act together and start putting out films that people want to see, so that kids are encouraged to get back onto the toy wagon. And number three, and this is one that I strongly agree with. Just because you put out a superhero movie doesn't necessarily mean you should fill the market with superhero toys of characters in that movie, especially when the movie tanks. So when a film like The Eternals comes out and it does badly, do we really need action figures for all the characters? The answer is no. When Thor Love and Thunder tanks, do we really need action figures for King Valkyrie? No. Do we really need action figures for Lady Thor? Of course not, because you killed her in the movie. Where's the incentive to buy that action figure? Same goes for Shang-Chi. It's an okay action film. It's fun. It's a good Marvel popcorn movie. But really, giant dragon toys and Shang-Chi kicking kung fu toys? Nobody's buying that. They're stacked on the corners of liquidation centers and end caps, and this is proving it. Just because you release a movie doesn't mean it needs action figures. And that even goes for big blockbusters too, like Wakanda Forever. $850 million at the box office doesn't mean we need Shuri action figures and Atuma action figures and Atuma headdresses and blankets, because none of that stuff is selling in a significant volume to fucking warrant such an outlay onto the market. I mean, Shuri macaroni and cheese is one thing, but action figures, we don't need them. And that goes for Ironheart too. So what is the answer? Do you agree with these comments? Do you think what the fans are right? Hey man, let me know in the comments section below. So what's the bottom line? The bottom line is this: we're not in the endgame. I don't believe we're in the endgame. We're more like in an infinity war, because I believe that Hasbro will get its act together. Likewise, I'm a firm believer that Marvel is going to pull up their socks, start producing films the fans want at a quality and a level that the fans deserve and have seen before. Likewise, I'm very enthusiastic about James Gunn and what he's doing at DC. I like it all. And I also love knockoff toys. And if you find amusement in them as much as I do, feel free to subscribe, comment to my channel, like it as well. My name is Johnny Bananas. This is Stark Raving Hazelnuts. And we'll see you again real soon, because I've got lots of cool stuff still to come.